to our inspirational message to be given to us by our head of the social work department from Loyola College, Jenna Yovivia, one of our MPI 2018 facilitator. Let us all welcome Gladstone City.
Good morning.
Good morning.
And now we say, Vanakkam.
Vanakkam.
It's so easy, people. Just like saying, Vanakkam. Yes, Vanakkam. Salaman. How do I inspire the people who are already inspired? What would be something like preaching to the choir? Because you are people who have already been converted. You are people on the side of peace. I remember a passage from the Bible when this crazy man called Jesus, he trained 72 people. And by the end of 3 years, almost 3 years, he sent out people to the field. He sent them two by two. And he used a phrase, I'm sending you as sheep among wolves. The world out there is waiting for us, is waiting to attack us. It is far more polluted than 3 weeks ago. It's far more arrogant than 3 weeks ago. It's far more violent than just 3 weeks ago. But you are literally in a resort, in an oasis of peace. This is a place where a father helps his son or daughter out to drive on a playground. So you are brought to this safe space to learn how to drive. The father says, turn left, my child. There are no vehicles coming. So you turn on the indicator and turn left. Or your mother who's teaching you to drive, my dear son, turn on the right indicator so that people will know that you are turning right and you turn left. And sure enough, there are no vehicles coming over here, so you go left, right, straight, everywhere. It is like your swimming teacher who teaches you to swim wearing the life jacket or a float. You learn to swim in a swimming pool. But in a week from now, you will have to take off that jacket. You will be on the main streets. Hopefully you don't learn to drive in India. There are no rules. Where a red light simply means a color of joy. You don't stop. A green light means that you keep going. And an orange light means stay ready as always. But your teachers over here did not teach you that. They said red light means stop. Orange light means be ready. And green light means go. The world out there is not like that. People don't understand your indicators for peace. People do not understand what you mean when you actually shout out peace. And this is where I'm reminded that you will be sheep among wolves. But peacebuilding work is about renewing your commitment for peace every day, disarming yourself, disarming others. Using the power of peace means staying calm, peaceful, and facing the challenges. I am a storyteller. And for many, many years, I have said stories based on my own experiences. I have used humor against violence. And using looking at terror in the eye and saying that I refuse to be violent in front of you. One day in Sri Lanka, it was very early in the morning, it was 5 o'clock. I was traveling with a group of women. It was during the war in 2007. The conflict was raging, and we had to go from Maui to Batipur, the eastern part of Sri Lanka. And it was a time when two militant groups, when one militant group had split into two. And it was heavily fortified. 5 o'clock in the morning, I was in a van. As usual, I sit in front because the locals sit behind. I always carry my passport in my pocket. Just before entering the tunnel area over there, I was stopped by a tall, hefty, black man carrying a Kalashnikov, an AK-47 gun. He was wearing a white t-shirt. He stopped our car. As usual, we have to roll down our window. I rolled down my window, and immediately he put a gun to my head. Immediately pointed the gun. It was 5 o'clock. It's not as bright as over there. The women, 8 women in my car, and the driver, we felt completely silent. We did not know what to do. I held the barrel of the gun. I pulled it down, looked at it in the eyes, paused for about 2 seconds, and said, "Have you eaten?" This boy was completely surprised. I'm pointing a gun at you, early morning at 5 o'clock, and what are you asking? Are you saying, "Have you eaten?" I could feel the chill of the barrel of the gun in my hand. Put it down. And I asked him, he looked back at me and said, "What are you asking?" I said, "You look really tired. You must have been standing here for the last 6 hours or so. And I just wanted to offer some snacks that we had." He looked at me and said, "Sir, nobody has asked me such a question. Where are you from?" I said, "I was from India. I took out my passport. You want to check my passport? But who do you have in your car?" "So they're all my staff. They're traveling with me." And he asked me, "Are you not afraid?" He said, "No." But I asked him back, "You look like you could use this bag for me." I took out a bag of sandwiches, and as in Sri Lanka, they got shopkeets. Some shopkeets and offered to him. He immediately received it. And he said, "Thank you, sir," and showed us the way. This is one of those unforgettable experiences that is etched in my heart, where this strong, militant man, who was just about to pull the trigger, within a second I would have gone, and all the people with me would have gone, was so anxious. He was waiting, not for food, not for anything else, but one word of empathy. To look at him and say, "What are your needs?" At that moment, I saw him transform. I asked him, "Why are you taking us like this?" And he gave me a whole story, and we paused for 10, 15 minutes, and then he went. In the meantime, people behind me were digging behind my seat and said, let's go. Don't stop here. But friends, this is just one story of the millions of stories many of you have, and I'll tell you. everyday life, in checkpoints when I've been stopped in Sri Lanka or in Afghanistan or in Pakistan or any part of South Asia where I've traveled, I've held it on and said, I am a peace builder. And peace builders need to be creative. Peace builders need to be reference points for action. I'm a peace builder who will remain as a reference point for action. I refuse to be violent. Even when the world is coming violent against me, I refuse to be violent. And I opt for reconciliation. And reconciliation for me is three types. First, reconcile with your own situation. It's personal reconciliation. And that means, this is the world that I've been given to. First, I accept it as it is. Second, reconcile with my own family and my community, because I have caused a lot of damage. And third, reconciliation with the world and with the systems. That doesn't mean we don't fight against it. Reconciling does not mean to quietly accept. As a human rights activist for the last 25 years, I know what it is to stand up and speak truth to power. So friends, you are invited in this third week to stay strong, to stay motivated, and remember, nothing ever can upset you, because you are a seed of peace. You are a tree of peace. And always remember, no tree keeps its fruit for itself. Has any tree kept its fruit for itself? Have you ever seen any tree eating its own fruit? No, never. You are that tree that is inviting these young boys and girls to throw stones. Come on, throw stones at me and take my fruit. Does any tree say, stop throwing stones at me? No. The owner of the tree may say, but the tree doesn't say. It says, take my fruits. Little birds, come eat fruits from me. Sit on my branches. Create your nests. And make more babies and multiply peace builders. So we are talking about being that tree, that source of peace. Be that river that refuses to drink from its own water. No river drinks from its own stream. The river is for people to give. So peace is to give. Be that unflinching giver of peace. And radiate peace. Stay motivated. Thank you very much.